Half-Life 2 is one of my favorite games of all time and holds a special place in my heart, not only because it absolutely blew everyone's minds when it came out and changed video games forever, but also because it was set in a kind of environment that was rarely seen before in any game. Games before it have taken us around fictional universes and the Western world, with a ton of massively popular games of all genres being inspired by and being set mostly in the United States or Western Europe. Half-Life 2 did something different. City 17, with its dystopian post-Soviet aesthetic, was a breath of fresh air that introduced many people worldwide to a kind of setting they've never seen before. I also really like City 17 because I practically live in it. Check out this video recorded like a week ago. Yeah guys, they made Half-Life 2 into a real thing. That's kinda crazy, dude. Back in 2004, City 17 was new, exciting, and different. It's such an incredible fusion of the historical architecture of Eastern Europe and characteristic Soviet buildings with the inhuman, grotesque, and gargantuan constructions of the Combine that tower over the old city, almost swallowing it. Pretty much anyone who's ever seen the skyline of City 17 once will remember it forever. The juxtaposition between the old buildings and the massive Citadel Tower created one of the most memorable worlds in any video game period. Half-Life 2 started a trend. Post-Soviet locations have become pretty standard in the video game industry nowadays. The Stalker series with its post-apocalyptic Chernobyl exclusion zone, PUBG, Arma 2, Escape from Tarkov, Call of Duty Warzone, the Metro series. More and more games today are inspired by post-Soviet countries and Eastern Europe than ever, and City 17 is definitely responsible for that. I've always been fascinated by City 17 and the world of Half-Life 2, and in the wake of the recent release of Half-Life Alyx and the overall increased interest in the Half-Life series of the general public, I decided to look into what City 17 was actually based on and inspired by. In this video, we're going to look at how City 17 was created, what was the inspiration behind it, and what it resembles the most in the end. I'm going to be mostly using Half-Life 2 and its episodes as a reference because, let's be honest, most of Half-Life Alyx is just interiors, and I don't have VR either. We are going to look at some stuff from Alyx as well though, because that game kind of confirms City 17's actual location. Anyway, without further ado, it is your boy Roman, your favorite neighborhood Russian, and today we're going to be discussing the origins of Half-Life 2's City 17. Half-Life 2's art style was a combined work of many talented artists, however, one of them was the most important. City 17, as well as most of the combined technology and architecture, was designed by Viktor Antonov, an art director and conceptual artist that is famous for his work in the video game industry and his unique style. Apart from working on Half-Life, Antonov also worked as the art director for Arkane's Dishonored series, so if you've ever wondered why that game looks like Half-Life so much, here's your answer. Viktor Antonov was born in Sofia, the capital of Bulgaria, which, if you don't know, is a country in Eastern Europe that was also heavily affiliated with the Soviet Union. Basically, that means that Sofia has all of the goodies we're looking for, historical Eastern European buildings as well as Soviet commie blocks. However, let's not get ahead of ourselves here. When Half-Life 2's initial development started, the Eastern European setting was not yet established. According to Half-Life 2 Raising the Bar, Valve's book about the game's development, the initial vision of the game included a vast array of different locations, taking Gordon Freeman all the way from Washington DC to the Middle East, from the remains of the Earth to alien fortress cities. However, those ideas never quite made it, and the idea of a dystopian city run by alien invaders as a setting was born. The initial version of City 17 was quite different to what we got in the final game. The oldest concept art shows City 17 as being more of an American city, featuring skyscrapers and architectural elements you'd see in a modern American metropolis. At this stage in development, Valve was mainly doing location research in Seattle, basing a lot of the in-game assets and textures on photos taken in the United States. In fact, thanks to the Half-Life 2 beta leak in 2003 and the work of the modding community, we can now take a look at a lot of the original maps that showed what City 17 looks like around 1999 or 2000. City 17 was an American East Coast-like city based on Washington, DC. In the old City 17, it was never sunny. It was much darker, grittier, and fit the game's early art design. The world of early Half-Life 2 featured an even more Orwellian dystopian society, in which the Combine replaced the air with poisonous gas, which made everyone wear masks, and the Combine also used child labor. All of this was cut from the final game. Around 2001, the initial concept was scrapped, and City 17 became what we know it as today. For a while, it still didn't quite look like the final version, even with the Citadel being different, but the idea was there. It was now an Eastern European city. City 17 is a mix of many different post-Soviet and Eastern European cities, featuring buildings and elements from many different countries. The main inspiration, however, was Viktor Antonov's birthplace, Sofia. In his 2016 Reddit AMA, Viktor Antonov was asked about the main inspirations behind City 17, and this was his response. "It was based on my childhood city Sofia in Bulgaria. It had mixed elements from Belgrade and St. Petersburg. I wanted to capture the specific atmosphere of Eastern and Northern Europe." According to Raising the Bar, in the early stages of the development of the new Eastern European City 17, Valve gathered photographic reference material from Bulgaria, Russia, and Romania. In the book, Antonov is quoted with saying that one of the reasons that Eastern Europe was chosen as a setting is because it represents the collision of the old and the new in a way that is difficult to capture in the United States. You go over there and you have this collision between all of these things. The new architecture, the old architecture, the fall of communism. There's a sense of this strongly grounded historical place. We left out the gothic themes associated with Prague and vampires and looked into a different aspect of the region. Sofia inspired the look of City 17 in the smallest details, from the overall lighting to the individual look of buildings and textures, which can be seen in the reference images featured in Valve's book. Russia was more of an inspiration for the Soviet look and architecture, such as the omnipresent commie blocks, as well as being an inspiration for a lot of the locations outside the city. For example, Nova Prospect, which was literally called the Gulag in the early development stages. Russia also inspired some locations in Episode 1 and 2, mainly the hospital in Episode 1 and the Victory Mine in Episode 2. Russian and Bulgarian are also the two main languages that can be seen on posters, signs, and props throughout Half-Life 2 and Alyx. Both of these languages are written in a Cyrillic script, so if you're only an English speaker, then you wouldn't be able to decipher between the two. Don't worry though, I got you. I'm a native Russian speaker, and I will help you understand what is going on when we talk about the languages used throughout City 17. Apart from Russia and Bulgaria, there are many other countries that inspired City 17 in tons of different ways. Let's look at some individual locations and objects within Half-Life 2's world and try to track down their origins. Let's start with a City 17 train station that the player arrives to at the beginning of the game. It's based on a real train station designed by the Eiffel Company, located in Budapest, the capital of Hungary. The stations practically look the exact same, although Viktor Antonov says that the final iteration of the station and its interior was more closely based on a train station near which he lived in Paris, which is the Gare Saint-Lazare. The Overwatch Nexus building in City 17 is basically an identical copy of the building of the Parliament of Serbia located in Belgrade, which makes sense considering that Antonov himself mentioned Belgrade as one of the biggest inspirations. Not only that, but Half-Life 2 also features a Serbian car Zastava 101 as one of the wrecks laying around the city and its outskirts. Speaking of the wrecked cars featured in the game as props, most of them are based on Soviet cars that were widespread in Russia and the rest of the USSR, in particular the Volga, the Zaz, the Moskvich, and the Zill trucks. One of the wrecks also closely resembles an East German Trabant. I assume that the developers just decided to use every single Eastern Bloc and Soviet car imaginable for the scenery, which I love. It was always really fun to see cars you see outside in Russia or a car that your grandfather drove on the streets of City 17. There are a few other major cities that are usually named as inspirations and are compared to City 17. For example, Riga, the capital of Latvia, which features a skyline and an architectural style similar to that of City 17. Vilnius, the capital of Lithuania, which features narrow streets similar to ones in City 17. St. Petersburg, Russia, which is not only one of the biggest inspirations according to Antonov, but also is similar to City 17 in the way that it has no skyscrapers in the city center and features a lot of canals. Not only that, but St. Petersburg has their own real-life citadel now, and it is uncanny. I should make a vlog on it or something, I swear to God. The other city that is often mentioned is Odessa, Ukraine, which is a coastal city just like City 17. In-game, there is also a settlement outside of City 17 called New Little Odessa, which might be a reference to the Ukrainian city. City 17 is also often compared to Sevastopol, Crimea, which is a port city on the Black Sea. The coastal terrain immediately outside of City 17 is very similar to the shores and coasts of the Black Sea around Sevastopol. The extensive network of docks and harbor facilities seen in some chapters is consistent with Sevastopol's status as a major port and the base of the Russian Black Sea naval fleet. Lastly, there are the Romanian cities of Constanța and Bucharest, which feature a lot of the buildings similar to those in City 17. The coastal pass in the Half-Life 2 chapter Highway 17 also features some similarities to the Romanian coast. Moreover, the train station timetable in Half-Life 2 actually has writings in the Romanian language on it, and Romanian can be seen on a few other signs in the game. Now let's get to the most interesting part, the languages used on signs, props and writings throughout Half-Life 2 and its episodes, as well as the new information from Half-Life Alyx, which basically confirms City 17's actual location. City 17 features a lot of Bulgarian writing. One clear example is Cement or Cement, which is written across the top of a large building in Ravenholm, and the only language that spells the word cement in this way using the Cyrillic alphabet is Bulgarian. Also, in Half-Life 2, a newspaper prop can be seen entitled Rabotnicheskoe Delo. This was a real Bulgarian newspaper, being the most popular in Bulgaria during its communist period. There is a ton of Russian writing in Half-Life 2 as well, the most prominent examples being the hospital sign in Episode 1, which says «Stationar», as well as the victory mine in Episode 2, which says «Шахта Победы имени 50-летия», which isn't even grammatically correct or makes that much sense, because I think they were trying to say «Шахта имени 50-летия Победы», but whatever. Regardless, it's pretty damn Russian. Half-Life Alyx features even more Bulgarian writings. For example, electrical panels have warnings in Bulgarian written on them. There are also quite a few advertisements in the city that are in Bulgarian. Once again, I don't personally own a VR headset and I have not yet played Alyx, but just by looking at an online walkthrough, it seems to me that there is far more Russian text in the game. It can be seen on tons of props and signs, and apparently even the newspapers featured in the game that are talking about in-game events are also written in Russian. Moreover, the in-game chapter that takes place at a zoo features a ton of text and all of it is in Russian. Instead of showing you guys tons of examples, I wanted to point out one very interesting detail that I've noticed. In a sequence in the beginning of the game, when Alyx has to get on the train to get to the quarantine zone, an interesting poster can be seen inside the interior of the train. It's some sort of beer advertisement in Russian, but what's more interesting is that the advertisement is actually written using the pre-revolutionary, pre-reformed Russian orthography, using letters and rules that have been omitted in 1918 by the newly formed Soviet government. Here's the reason why I find this very interesting. Half-Life Alyx basically confirms that City 17 is indeed Sofia, the capital of Bulgaria, because in the game you actually have the map of the city, which appears during loading screens. The fans were able to extract the model from the game and make a fan-made 2D map based on this in-game map, and if you lay it on top of the real city of Sofia, it's exactly the same. It is actually bizarre how similar it is, since even the roads line up to real-life roads in Sofia. Another interesting detail is that at the beginning of Half-Life Alyx, a globe can be seen and interacted with, on which the US is crossed out, and the globe has an arrow drawn on it pointing to a massive circled zone within Eastern Europe, which basically confirms that City 17 is an Eastern European city. Here's the thing, if City 17 really is in Bulgaria, then what's up with this old pre-USSR times Russian posters laying around the city? And why is so much of the text in the game in Russian? It really messes with my brain. I assume that the developers at Valve just decided that ultimately nobody would really care and that to someone who can't read Cyrillic in the first place, it will make no difference. Most people can't even tell the difference between Russian and Bulgarian anyway, because they look exactly the same to them. But to me, it does matter. And it does matter to millions of Russians and Bulgarians arguing online right now whether City 17 is Russian or Bulgarian. Come on, Valve. We don't need any more tensions between the Slavic nations. But well, I guess it's not so bad. I mean, after all, City 17 and Half-Life 2 did not have any linguistic consistency either, featuring text in Bulgarian, Russian, and Romanian. So this time, we're at least sticking to the Cyrillic script, which is good. So I guess, guys, this is what you clicked this video for. This is the ultimate answer to what inspired City 17 and what it's actually based on. It's either every single Eastern European city imaginable, or Sofia, the capital of Bulgaria. Let's just give it to the Bulgarians, okay? You guys win. City 17 is yours. Заверш вам. Поздравления за победата ви, приятели. Anyways, guys, that is going to be pretty much it for today's video. I hope you guys did like this little excursus into the history of City 17 and what it was inspired by. If you guys did enjoy this video, please make sure to subscribe to my channel for more Russian and post-Soviet stuff. And also, guys, if you want to support my channel, make sure to go over down in the description to my Patreon link. Support it. I would gladly appreciate it. And it actually helped me out a lot. Thank you guys so much once again for watching this video. And I will see you guys in the next one. Peace.